To use a UV curing adhesive to glue together things like resin or glass, like this is particularly is a transparent adhesive, anything that you need to be transparent or bonded well, or that you need to be able to work with until you're ready to cure it. You know, you don't want it to cure too slowly or too quickly. You want to be able to control the curing. A UV curing adhesive is a very good solution for that. This Loctite A349 is a one of very many formulations of adhesive. This one retains some flexibility. It cures rapidly and it's very strong. And I use it for curing parts to resin or curing parts that are going to be inside of resin, because I use alumilite polyurethane resin. And when you put this stuff in alumilite, it pretty much disappears. As long as you cure the adhesive properly. Now, the other tools you will need is a light source to cure this adhesive. And in this case, I mostly do spot applications of the adhesive. So I use a little flashlight like this, which you just push on the end to turn on, and it's a UV flashlight. And you do not want to look into that because it's very strong. It has two settings. It has a high and a low setting, and the high setting cures very quickly. The low setting is cures quickly also, but kind of a little bit more controlled curing. The high setting definitely, like, it cures stuff almost instantaneously depending on the thickness. The 365 nanometer cures everything inside of the surface. On the surface can still be tacky after you cure it with this. You either need a different wavelength to finish curing the surface, or you can submerse it underwater and cure it underwater, and it cures the surface. Basically, it needs to be in the absence of air, oxygen, I believe, in order to cure. So it's like an oxygen-inhibited UV adhesive. And many UV resins and adhesives are oxygen-inhibited curing. So you have to either submerge them underwater to do the final curing of the surface, or in a special gas that's inert, or use a different wavelength light, but it's hard to find that different wavelength light that you need for that. Sometimes a fluorescent UV or an arc type UV lamp, it has a much wider spectrum, and it will do a better job of curing those wavelengths, but those lamps are very expensive, they're bulky, they're fragile. This works, and then I just dunk the stuff in water, or just put a light coating of water over it and cure it, and then just clean it off, dry it off. The other thing you're gonna need are some safety glasses, and make sure you get some good quality UV safety glasses. So you'll see that these safety glasses completely stop the UV from passing through. I mean, you just see a very tiny bit, and that could be partially visible light. There is a filter on the front of this that that's supposed to stop most of the frequencies that are outside of the range of what you're trying to get. And last but not least is gloves. You want to use gloves when you're handling this adhesive. You really don't want to be touching resins and polyurethanes and epoxies with your hands, because your hands can get a sensitivity to those things, and you'll have allergies when later if you handle them too much with your hands. So use rubber gloves at all times. These UV LED strips are an alternate way of curing UV resins and UV adhesives. You have to make sure that you get the correct wavelength for your application. The majority of these UV LED strips are in the like 395 to 410 nanometer range. And that I tested that with this specific adhesive right here, which is a 365 nanometer adhesive. And they did not work with this resin. They worked with the 3D printing resin, which has about a 405 nanometer wavelength curing sensitivity. But in this case, for this adhesive, I had to buy some special 365 nanometer UV LED strips, which were quite a bit more expensive than the other ones, and they were hard to find too. I had to buy them from a specialty LED place, but they work. They cure the adhesive with no issue. So I just have them inside of a bucket here, and I can place my items inside of the bucket and then put a lid on it and cure it. And I can also place this bucket inside of a pressure pot and cure inside of a pressure pot.